Welcome to Rodney's Publishing. Viewings for my shorts can be found on my YouTube channel. Be sure to subscribe and tell a friend. Bookshelves overflowed, threatening to spill their contents onto the worn rug. A chipped mug resided permanently on the coffee table, a testament to Charles's late-night reading habit. The air held the faint scent of old paper and brewing coffee, a comforting aroma that had become a constant in Charles's life. A single window overlooked a bustling street, its sounds muted by the double-paned glass. Charles lived a life of quiet routine. His days were marked by a series of predictable events, each one flowing seamlessly into the next. Every morning he would rise at precisely 7 a.m., his internal clock so finely tuned that he often woke just moments before the alarm. The shrill cry of his alarm clock, a jarring contrast to the peaceful silence of his apartment, was a sound he had grown accustomed to, a necessary evil to start his day. He would then go through the motions of making coffee, always two scoops black, just the way he liked it. The aroma of freshly brewed coffee filled the air, a small pleasure that never failed to bring a slight smile to his face. The morning news provided a backdrop to his breakfast, his eyes scanning the headlines while his mind slowly came alive. He would read about the world outside, a world that seemed so distant from his own. His was a life devoid of grand adventures, yet it was a life he found strangely comforting. The predictability of his routine was a source of solace, a buffer against the chaos of the outside world. After breakfast, Charles would take a leisurely walk in the nearby park. The fresh air and the sound of birds chirping were a welcome change from the confines of his apartment. He would often sit on a bench, watching the world go by, lost in his thought. On some days, he would visit the local library, a place he found both peaceful and stimulating. He would browse through the shelves, picking up books that caught his interest, and spend hours reading in a quiet corner. Evenings were spent in much the same way as his mornings. He would cook a simple dinner, often a recipe he had perfected over the years. The act of cooking was therapeutic, a way to unwind after the day. After dinner, he would either watch a bit of television or read a book before heading to bed. His nights were as predictable as his days, a cycle that repeated itself with comforting regularity. As he lay in bed, he would reflect on his day, finding contentment in the simplicity of his life. He knew that his routine might seem mundane to others, but to him it was a source of peace and stability. Charles understood that life didn't have to be filled with excitement to be fulfilling. Sometimes the quiet moments, the small rituals, and the familiar patterns were enough to bring a sense of purpose and joy. And so he embraced his routine, finding beauty in the ordinary and contentment in the everyday. The fire alarm sliced through his sleep, its insistent wail ripping him from a dream. Disoriented, Charles stumbled out of bed, his mind struggling to make sense of the sudden noise. Thick smoke, acrid and choking, filled the air, instantly triggering a primal fear within him. He coughed, his eyes stinging as he realized with a jolt of terror that this was no ordinary dream. His apartment was on fire. The hallway was a scene of chaos. His neighbors, faces contorted in fear, rushed past him, their shouts and screams echoing off the walls. The air was thick with smoke, making it difficult to breathe. Children clung to their parents, their cries adding to the cacophony. Charles felt a surge of panic rising within him, threatening to overwhelm his senses. His eyes darted around his smoke-filled apartment, desperately trying to decide what to take with him. His laptop, filled with years of hard work, the photo albums holding precious memories of his beloved family. His mind raced, unable to settle on anything. He knew he couldn't take it all, that every second wasted brought him closer to the inferno consuming his home. Panic seized him and he finally made a decision. Grabbing his wallet and phone, the only essentials he could think of, he stumbled towards the door. Heat scorched his skin as he fumbled with the lock, his fingers trembling. The doorknob felt unbearably hot and he cried out as it seared his palm. With a final desperate push, he burst into the hallway, the heat and smoke hitting him like a physical blow. The hallway was a raging inferno. Flames licked at the walls, casting an eerie orange glow on the smoke-filled air. The fire had started just minutes ago, but it had already spread with a ferocity that was almost supernatural. The once familiar corridor was now an alien landscape of heat and danger, every surface a potential threat. The heat was unbearable, sucking the air from his lungs and making it difficult to breathe. Each breath felt like inhaling shards of glass, the smoke thick and acrid, burning his throat and lungs. He could feel the sweat pouring down his face, mixing with the soot and grime, stinging his eyes and blurring his vision. He could hear the roar of the fire as it consumed everything in its path, a terrifying symphony of destruction. The crackling of burning wood, the shattering of glass, and the occasional explosive pop of something igniting filled the air, creating a cacophony that was both mesmerizing and horrifying. The fire was alive, a beast that devoured everything it touched. Charles coughed, his eyes stinging, his throat raw from the smoke. He could feel the panic rising in his chest, threatening to overwhelm him, but he forced it down, knowing that giving in to fear would be fatal. He had to stay focused, had to find a way out. The smoke was so thick now that he could barely see a few feet in front of him, every step a gamble. He knew he had to keep moving, that every second counted. The fire was relentless, and he could feel its heat nipping at his heels, urging him forward. He thought of his family, of the promise he had made to them to come back safe. That thought gave him strength, a reason to push through the pain and fear. He moved quickly, his mind racing, trying to remember the layout of the building, to find the quickest route to safety. The hallway seemed endless, each turn revealing more flames, more obstacles. But he didn't stop. He couldn't stop. His survival depended on his determination, on his will to live. And so, through the inferno, he ran. He stumbled out of the building, collapsing onto the sidewalk, gasping for air. The cool night air filled his lungs, a welcome relief from the suffocating heat. He lay there for a moment, his body racked with coughs, his mind struggling to comprehend what had just happened. Around him, chaos reigned as his neighbors, some injured, others weeping, gathered on the street, their faces illuminated by the dancing flames of the inferno that had once been their home. He opened his eyes, his vision blurry, the flickering glow of a television cast dancing shadows on the familiar walls of his apartment. The scent of burnt toast filled the air, a stark contrast to the acrid smell of smoke that lingered in his senses. He lay on his couch, a throw blanket draped over him. The news played softly on the television, a story about a fire in a nearby apartment building. Relief washed over him as he realized that it had all been a dream, a terrifyingly vivid nightmare, the kind that leaves you breathless, heart racing, and drenched in sweat. He could still feel the remnants of fear clinging to his skin, the echoes of his own screams reverberating in his mind. It was as if he had been transported to another world. One where danger lurked around every corner and safety was a distant memory. The fear, the heat, the desperate scramble for survival, all of it had been a figment of his sleeping mind. Yet it felt so real, so tangible. He could almost smell the acrid smoke, feel the searing heat against his skin, and hear the deafening roar of chaos. It was a nightmare that had gripped him with such intensity that even now, awake and aware, he struggled to shake off its hold. He sat up, his heart still pounding, and reached for the remote, turning off the television and its unsettling news report. The images on the screen had likely seeped into his subconscious, fueling the horrors of his dream. The news had been filled with stories of disasters, conflicts, and tragedies, each one more harrowing than the last. It was no wonder that his mind had conjured such a terrifying scenario. The silence that descended was almost deafening, a stark contrast to the roaring inferno that still echoed in his ears. It was a silence that felt heavy, almost oppressive, as if the very air around him was holding its breath. He could hear the faint hum of the refrigerator, the distant sounds of the city outside. But within his room, there was a stillness that seemed to amplify the remnants of his fear. He was safe in his own apartment, surrounded by the familiar comforts of home, the soft glow of the bedside lamp, the cozy warmth of his blankets, the framed photos of loved ones on the wall. All these things grounded him, reminding him of the reality he was in. It was a stark contrast to the chaos of his dream, a sanctuary of peace and familiarity. It had all been a dream, a terrifying reminder of the fragility of life and the unexpected ways in which it could be upended. He found himself reflecting on the nature of fear, how it could grip the mind and twist reality into something unrecognizable. Dreams, he realized, had a way of revealing our deepest anxieties, our most profound fears. They were a window into the subconscious, a mirror reflecting the turmoil within. As he sat there, the remnants of his nightmare slowly fading, he couldn't help but feel a sense of gratitude. Gratitude for the safety of his home, for the loved ones in his life, and for the simple fact that he was awake, alive, and in control of his reality. The dream had been a harrowing journey, but it had also been a reminder of the resilience of the human spirit, the ability to wake up, shake off the fear, and face a new day with renewed strength. Thank you for your time. Stay tuned to Rodney's Publishing and share with a friend.